the end of 8 minutes, we will know who the champion of this Jamaica Basketball Showcase, which team would walk away with the trophy. Right now, the team in fourth position is looking to do that on your screen. The Amsterdam Giants, led by Coach Hill. They are the ones, if they can hold on to this 12-point lead or extend it, or at least keep this Caribbean Basketball Academy as far away as possible, even if it's just by a point, then they can walk away as champions. But the CBA team, just as the skin on their jerseys indicate, they can be venomous.
Yes, they can.
Well, like Rodney said, once you put a run on them, they sort of give up. So that's what it looked like. Let's see if they bring it out in this fourth quarter with energy.
So, Campanile Giants, they'll have first possession of this quarter.
Looks like a limited kind of man defense.
8-12. The score in favor of CBA at the end of the first quarter. Then the lead changed with the Giants 18-50 at the half.
Looked like they changed to noon.
And now 32-20. The Stars as we enter the fourth. So foul on Swinnett.
Quick call by the referee there.
CBA came out in a man-to-man defense. They switched it up.
Not handling the ball here. Seagree
passes. Well, just tossed the ball up at the back. And the ball gone.
Foul committed by number 14, Gale.
Chance of defense coming from the Giants bench. Look at Spence on Brown. He's hurt over him.
There's who we're asking for. Where has he been the last few minutes of this, of the last quarter?
Bruce Livingston just threw it out.
Yeah, he got blocked in on KG.
You saw what happened there?
Yes.
Player was trying to get around him. He just stepped over like he was shadowing in football. There it is right there.
Box him out from getting to the ball.
Yeah.
At least he did box him out.
This time.
Brown with the jumper off. Gavin with the ball with the rebound.
Oh, what a nice toss from Austin. A Hail Mary prayer, I would imagine, but.
Well, he figured out that he planned it. Momentum shifting to Caribbean Basketball Academy.
And he's had about three straight turnovers, Gale. I replaced him and put McGowan back in.
But this is definitely the energy that CBA needs, apart from that turnover right there.
Powerful move. Good spin move. Wow.
McGowan, the big man.
And our fan coach is happy with seeing how CBA started, but she didn't like that finish.
Livingston now, 2 more points. Lead back to 10. This is bucket for a bucket.
You can't keep trading buckets.
They have to put a stop. They need more stops than buckets, do CBA.
And they get one there. That's how a kickball is called.
Kickball. I was about to say, why don't somebody flash middle? The middle is wide open.
Yeah, just off Ricketts there. And after calling so long for Ricketts, he's finally on the court for him.
Yeah.
Coach wants sure-handed people on the court. Where hamper that.
Good intention, didn't finish.
So now this is heated up. First, this is Wales with his one. 10 points separating both teams. Austin. Oh. So the 3 second lane violation is called again on Urquhart. So he's getting in there and he's just watching the game.
Getting in there and standing in there.
Yeah. If he wants to watch a game, he can use a sports mask app.
Saw what you did there.
Oh, yeah. Goes up the
Nobody's going to challenge him, though.
He's hurt. The guy on his hurt.
He came down straight on his tailbone.
And there's two
refs. The refs are going to turn up.
He's up now. He's back up.
So they're trading points.
There's too much dribbling. Too much dribbling. Too much dribbling.
So Morris will go to the line.
Nope, no free throws on that one.
Okay.
Side out.
I thought it was a shooting foul. Steve Udo, he lets one fly. Brown to the corner. Livingston goes up. And by the time it left,
you seen it when it left his hand, it was up.
Brown had Austin wide open at the top, but didn't see him.
Catless, a big rebound.
Is somebody going to grab a rebound?
Some to play, almost halfway through this final quarter. Still a lot of work to do.
Michael loses the ball.
Brown gets one swing, goes all the way and scores.
8 point lead.
It's cut below 10, and a timeout is called immediately.
And that's the kind of play the coach is looking for, Coach Barker, but Brown might have injured himself on that last fall again. He's not necessarily 100% because he injured himself in the last two games in the same area doing pretty much the same thing.
Yeah.
Coming down hard after a layup.
He's going all out.
Well, he's leaving it on the floor, which is where he needs to, but at the same time, he's got to be careful. And there we see assistant fan coach.
that's a fan for CBA?
Yeah. And there you see Brown. Taking some much needed deep breaths while he sits and gets some water and hydrates. Coach Barker happy with the run that they just made. They got themselves 4 quick points to bring this lead down to 8.
Again, CBA needs to play some defense. They're not really boxing out on the board.
Well, what they're trying to do is scrap, which is why I believe they went to the man defense. So they're trying to get the ball before it even gets to the point of a shot. So the hope is that they never have to go up for a rebound. That what they're trying to do is get the ball early.
The coach says one stop.
they need one stop every time.
So she obviously knows.
And if they can get the stops and score on the other end, then they're back in it in a bigger way.
And they're still covering the same footprint. Gavin Austin must be tired.
He must be, but that's Coach Barker's method. He did that against phase one when they put same Austin on Royal.
LeBron with the three. So
misses again. Good attempt there by Brown.
Well done. Which one got on the pitch?
Well, Lewinson made him change that shot a little bit. Oh, come on, big boy.
No, he didn't get the foul, so he gave the foul.
All right, so I'm seeing Campbell fade a little bit.
I see he was expecting a foul call there. He just didn't get it.
He gave it.
The ball. Yeah.
He's on 2 fouls now, if I'm correct.
He should be on 3 or 4. It's the fourth quarter.
Cowboys back up to 10. Now, if you look at the buckets, if you count them, if they had scored, the score right now would be in favor of Caribbean Basketball Academy. If they missed four shots.
Yeah. If they were making their shots, this game would be a whole lot tighter, a whole lot closer.
It could have easily been locked at 38.
Oh, very good defense.
He always does.
He never lets up. And that's why he's the assigned defender of anybody they want to shut down.
And he's small at that.
That's fine. It's just how big his heart is.
He's got
the biggest heart for real.
That was a
and the thing is, when you look at it, he does check whoever he has and check their scoring a lot. Because it affected Royal in the phase one game, and it's now starting to slow down
Swain.
Yeah.
Well, he's been on Swain the whole game.
Well, Swain got the better of him early, but not anymore. Yeah, more like a dance step.
Tango, maybe.
Everybody saw that. Especially McGowan.
Campbell tries to get to the hole. And then he's fouled. Two free throws for him. See what he does. Knocks down the post.
Much needed right now if they're ever going to have a chance.
1:56 left. No box out again. Nobody boxed out from the foul.
Ricketts made Camperdown pay for that. They now have the ball back. Now make them pay, Campbell.
There you go. So now the lead is cut to 7. Swain bumped Austin and got two.
And left hand.
He literally dispatched Austin at the center court.
I think he got it in.
And he got hurt. Austin is hurt. He is hurt badly, and that's not something you see often.
But I think the elbow. Swain elbowed him. Let's take a look at it again. Yeah.
No. Oh, he stepped on his foot.
Oh.
It stepped on his left foot right there.
Yeah. Roll his
right there, the ankle rolled.
Yeah, I just want to say, I didn't see any elbow.
Austin is a tough guy. He said, I'm not coming off the court. You got to keep playing.
He puts me in the mindset of Isaiah Thomas from way back in the 80s.
Fierce.
Finally!
Jackpot.
He's been asking for that.
Oh, he was begging.
2 minutes, under 2 minutes, first time.
Seagate, will he answer back? And he does.
Just like that, they wiped it all away.
The lead. I don't think he called bank on that.
He definitely didn't.
Jackpot.
Now you warm up, bro.
So, 3 for 3 for 3.
But now they need a stop, and they got it right here with the same Livingston. And two more.
So now we have a game in our hands. 4. The lead is cut down to what was 13 points. It's now down to just 4 points. Under a minute to go. This is the stuff that finals are made of. Can they get another stop here? Morris on the dribble. He goes around. Kevin Gale.
Gotta stay still on that pitch.
Seagrave with the ball in hand. That one misses. Now, CBA have a chance to bring it down even further. Austin with the ball.
They need a stop, and they need a foul if it's not happening.
Just less than 30 seconds to go. Can we get something? Doesn't fall. They get back the rebound, though. And the foul. He'll go to the line. Oh, my goodness.
They did not need that shot.
Coach Bird is loving that Kevon Gill with the nice timely finish.
But Coach Mike is calling it correctly because CBA should have committed the foul earlier.
Yes.
Get them out the game so that they could at least get another possession to get a chance to tie it or even win.
I was looking for the foul. They never gave it.
Yeah. Well, he did give him a hard bump.
No,
the referees let it play.
He's supposed to foul Swain on the way up the court.
Yeah.
There's no way Swain should have came up the court under 24 seconds. They don't need to stop. They don't need to shoot. You don't need to shoot. You got to foul him. Swain forced the ball to shoot it. I would have kept the ball out.
Austin at the half court did give Swain a big bump, but they didn't call it.
All right. So we don't get the ball. We're foul. We don't get the ball right away. With a quick foul. All right. Fine.
Between there.
Let's go.
We'll do it. If he misses that, they still have a chance. Caribbean basketball. Caribbean can take it up court.
So right now it's must get the rebound on the miss. If it doesn't miss and it scores, it's a timeout immediately. Move the ball up court, try to get a quick three or a shot at the hoop. Yeah, so that get the ball, they'll get the ball at half court if they call the timeout.
And of course you gotta watch out for Livingston because you know they're gonna check him for a three-pointer.
So it's all down to this, make or break. If Gale misses, they have to clamor, box out, do everything they can to get the rebound. If he scores, the timeout has to come quickly.
Is this too much, too little?
Browns box out the shooter. They get the rebound. This Austin takes it up court. Can he find someone? LeBron. He's fouled. And it lands! A chance for a three-point play.
He missed his shots.
He's going to foul on foul.
He missed his shots early in the game. Gerard and Coach Mike was talking about it. He hasn't been making any shots. Now, he came up with the biggest 2 points in the life of CBA in this game.
Segree has to foul him to foul him. He let him get the ball up. Don't let him get the ball up.
Wow.
He thought he did enough. Because normally Patsy fouls seem to throw everybody off their game. So he thought he did enough with the little bump and the hand swipe.
The game's coming to an end. You got a foul to foul.
15 seconds.
Yes, no shots.
We just have 15 seconds on the clock. That is good enough time. It's a one-point game.
There's also the opportunity of Lewinson intentionally missing for the putback. How successful are those type of plays, Coach Mike?
It was just a 10-point game. So if Lewinson misses, they better box out.
If he tries to miss intentionally.
Yeah, I would. I mean, I wouldn't right now because you still have time to foul. You get the ball back.
Okay.
So if you make the shot, you down one. They get the ball, you got to foul. Put them on the line.
And absolutely.
And hope they miss.
Absolutely.
You want every point you can get right now.
Finish on
if you intentionally
three.
Miss, it doesn't one, mean you're going to get the ball back. And you're down two. But a moment ago, Coach Hurd was standing and cheering.
He's not standing right now, is he?
He's seated and worried.
Well, I don't think he's too worried.
Quick turnaround. It was just up 10. The game was comfortably in hand.
Free throw, two.
Bro is Gale throwing the ball to on his team.
I think he just wanted to get it away.
He just wants to get rid of the ball. You don't throw it to a white shirt. You have to throw it to a red shirt.
He was falling away to give him a little bit, just a little bit of credit there to say he went for it. He was surrounded by white shirts. He was falling away. He kind of just let the ball go with the hope that one of his teammates would have followed him up and tried to help him grab it.
If you don't see your color shirt, don't throw it.
Well, this is a final to remember.
Well, the song of celebration being played by the DJs a little bit early, but.
Well, now you don't want to foul, and you want to play hard defense.
So you're working with two things right now. Hopefully a steal, or at least to trap them and not allow them to
you
score.
Don't overplay.
So you're not overplaying, but you're also certainly not giving up the opportunity if it comes to you.
Right.
So, gentlemen,
let's see what play was set up in the huddle.
I want you to think about this as we get ready for the final 10 seconds, 11 seconds. Who's your finals MVP? Don't answer yet. Just hold on. Think about it and hold on to the answer. And they get it back, Caribbean Basketball Academy.
Sagree got the ball and Swain was trying to take it away from him. And Sagree fell.
Timeout call.
CBA calls timeout.
A chance to advance the ball.
Here we see it.
They can't advance the ball. It wasn't
you got
score.
It. Nobody touched him. It was him and Swain fighting for their own ball.
Yeah, Swain said, give me the ball.
Wow.
They can't advance the ball because it wasn't a score.
Yeah.
Good defensive cover by CBA at that point. They didn't let him see any kind of daylight. He was just completely covered, and that's why Swain had to come around and try to take the ball. But, of course, he didn't know who was coming behind him, so he was fighting and wrestling to try and keep it.
Well, all I know, it looks like a CBA crowd.
Well, they certainly seem to have more noise in the stands. And they do have two fan coaches.
Yes.
Who we see notably are now, well, they're not even in the stands anymore. I think they're on the, they're actually on the court somewhere. There she is.
There she is. There's the head fan coach. Her assistant is obviously elsewhere, probably thinking about some plays herself.
But we're going to run now. Let's see what they come out with after the timeout.
So after the timeout, I'm almost sure that Coach Hurd is going to send a full-court man-to-man defense.
Well, they still have Sagree on the court. I would have put Spence in. Is there something wrong with Spence?
I don't know. But they're now going to pick everybody up individually.
They advance the ball.
And in addition to picking everybody up individually, they're going to go hard against Brown and possibly Lewinson. Lewinson can beat you with a shot. Brown can beat you with a shot or a drive.
Final 7 seconds.
Why did they leave Lewinson by himself?
What a ball. Oh, he couldn't grab it. Lewinson gets a chance to put it up. Oh, my. Going to overtime.
Ricketts had the ball inside the lane and couldn't control it.
Ricketts was trying.
At this point.
To score before he got the ball.
Yeah.
We see what happened. Ricketts got caught like a deer in headlights.
We have Lasco Oates in the building.
He was just blinded right there. Like, what do I do? I have the ball. What do I do? What do I do?
Well, gentlemen, when we came into this quarter, there was a 12-point lead. Halfway through, there was a 10-point lead. With 2 minutes on the clock, there was still a 10-point lead.
Yes.
But now, they're going to overtime.
Turnovers.
It shows you both credit to everybody. We have to give credit to both teams for doing some things right and some things capitalized on the mistakes of the other team. So we are here in the second overtime of this competition.
Well, I know that Campanon Giants got used to the boxing one. And I said, why is CBA still in the boxing one? And they came out in the fourth quarter out of the boxing one. That's when the game changed.
Question is, do they continue it in the overtime 3 minutes that they have?
Well, they've been doing good man-to-man since the fourth quarter. I don't know how you would change.
Well, now comes the question of sustainability. Are they fatigued yet? Are they too tired? Are they
you're fatigued, but your energy has to keep you going.
So if we look back quickly at how things, how we got to this point, it's pretty clear that CBA, they came out 12 points behind, and then they went on a run.
Shots like that from Brown. And there he goes again.
And this is the fourth quarter.
So they were able to get a couple of baskets. One supplied there from Morris. When we thought that they were about to secure victory, if you looked at that one, Lewinson was also in the frame of mind that they were going to lose. But then he produced that and then this.
Remember, he hit two threes.
That was the second of the two threes that he hit. And then this reverse layup from Ricketts was very critical. Austin playing lockdown defense. They were able to get back the ball up the court. LeBron Lewinson converting the two and getting a foul. Converting that foul, that free throw.
Yeah.
And then we're here.
Yes, and it's CBA ball.
So starting off the overtime, CBA will inbound from half court. Full court pressure continues. The full man-to-man defense continues for Camperdown.
3 minute overtime.
And the matchup is, as it has been before, Brown being guarded by the number eight.
Yeah.
And this overtime is brought to you by Sportsmax, the Jamaica basketball showcase.
3 minutes on the clock. Not many people left sitting, most of them standing. Campbell takes a step on the lane, but he is shut down.
Gale says, get that out of here.
Trying to get up court. He does finally. I lose it to Trigger. Ball back in CBA's hand.
So that's a little bit of that. That's the over-anticipated excitement there for him. He just wants to be the
dagger. Jackpot. 48-45. Slight advantage now with CBA. We are sitting here and I'm sweating. Bullets. My hands are as nervous as theirs on the court. The man who got them here, who brought them to this point, the clutchest player in the CBA team for this game. He goes up and he lands!
A sweet teardrop over the outstretched hand of Gale, who's some 6 inches taller than him.
Way more than 6 inches. The other 6 inches.
I was just trying to make it not look so bad.
The score is fine. 3 points still separate these two teams. Hugo to the line.
Wow,
two.
What a game.
And he's pacing up and down.
One of the CBA players are down.
Looks like Lewinson might be wanting to be down at this point.
Absolutely not. What you definitely don't want to end up with is a situation of trading baskets, as you see Swain there making that bucket.
That is Campbell.
Oh, he's Campbell. Well, he too is another one you don't want to be down.
He got hit in the face.
He's up now, though.
Shaking it off.
Brown. Coming up to focus.
McGowan just gave Brown a slight chest bump. Brown is.
Blue SS newspaper. This is good. They come down with it. Yeah.
situation. Big man move from the big man right there. But this time.
Falling out of the ring though.
Foul on Campbell, and that's his fourth. Only a 5-point lead. If you are Camperdown, you need these two. You don't want them, you need them. And if you don't get the shot, you have to be focused enough to make the box out and try to get the rebound.
Yes. Swing. He's back at the line. We usually would say that you don't need to worry about him being there, but we need to worry about him being there.
There's still 118 left. There's a lot of time left here.
Yeah, 4 points down. And this is the second. But Aldana tries to get it back. Tries to flip for the foul. Murphy doesn't even look at him. And Brown goes down the other way. Uses it.
He didn't touch it, right?
No, he had it in his hand. And rolled up in his hand.
Let's look at it again.
Let's look at it again.
That's where he lost it.
So yep. He did not.
He rolled up his hand.
He's the one that hit it that way.
Mars hit the ball, but it rolled off the Browns' hand.
All right.
Yeah. All right. And I'll take you with Mike on that one.
All right. I'm out voted this time.
Possession changes once again. Slowly this time the culprit.
If I'm not mistaken, that's a gimme. Let me give you back one.
Yeah, that's a good block there from Tampa. Good hustle there.
CBA is on the floor.
Not giving anything up. Possession is in favor of.
Looks like CBA gets it back. No.
Nope, it's the Giants. So the longer they can keep them at bay and avoid points being delivered by the Giants, CBA have a very good opportunity of walking out of here as champions. You're going to get called for that. That's your fifth foul.
No basket on the ground.
That's your fifth foul, Mr. Campbell.
I think Campbell is out.
That's his fifth
foul.
That's
a big loss. Out. He's deaf. Yeah, there it is.
Well, that's Calabar versus Calabar. He knew Mark was going to do go up, but he,
yeah, but
he reversed him on that team. He said, last time I did this, so this time I'm going to do this.
This is Madara possession. Less than a minute. The lead still 4 points. Can he cut it down to three?
Everybody needs to box out defensively and offensively if they want to try and get it.
Brown has it. Gets it away. And Stewart
loses the ball. 37 seconds left. Might start with the three.
No good. They have it in hand. To lose it. Back to Ricketts.
I would have held the ball out. I would have pulled the ball out. Rough for it. There's no need to rush.
They didn't need to, but they had a very good look. It was a very good opportunity for Ricketts. Ricketts just did not finish.
Pull the ball back. One time off the clock.
He's not gonna make too many misses. So
exactly.
He's gonna start to hurt you now, going down the wire. If you continue to foul him.
Make us win.
So after this, 25 seconds on the clock, do you run the clock down or do you try to score?
Well, you definitely have to keep running because losing the ball like that is going to hurt you even worse.
Shot.
Seagree misses. Toss up point. Ricketts all over it.
Tie ball. 9 seconds left.
Possession should be CBA this time.
It's CBA ball, but he's got to foul that away.
My gosh, what a play this is.
Coach Hurd wants to talk about it real quick. Coach Barker not happy because they didn't have to be right there.
If LeBron would have pulled the ball out, you wouldn't be in this situation.
You would absolutely not be. But right now, LeBron is playing all out ball. So he's just going all out.
He's one of the top guards in the country. He has to know to pull it off.
Well, all of that, we'll chalk that up to experience at the end of this game. Let's see what happens, what he learns from this going forward.
2 points separating two of the best teams, obviously, because they're in the finals.
Well, they certainly made their stamp and their claim as being two of the best teams by how they got to the finals. The fact that they're here, yes, but how they got here, they had to play some basketball to get here. Through the energies and strengths of significant team players, but certainly as a team, they did what they had to do.
CBA came in second last year. This year, they want to be first.
Well, they were almost completely out of it.
Almost. Out of the timeout, we're live on Sportsmax. 11 seconds left.
11 seconds, you're inbounding the ball. Campbell has fouled out.
Another timeout is called.
This time, I believe it's by Coach Marker.
Yes.
Because he wanted to see what they came and set up.
See what they set up to see how to get the ball in.
And I say weaker only because they may not have the handles or they may not have the mindset to observe what's happening around them as quickly.
Well, we're on the court. 11 seconds left in this overtime period. Remember, 3 minutes we played.
Austin inbounding.
He's been inbounding the whole game. I questioned that earlier in my head, and I didn't say anything because that's a coach's decision.
That's fine.
And he makes good decisions with the ball. That's why he's there.
So, Lewinson, they're trying to find him. Ricketts gets it back
quick
to
foul.
Him.
Quick foul.
They're not fouling. Brown gets it back.
That's not who you want to foul.
You look at the top. So now, this one's pretty much over.
They let the clock run out without fouling. You got to foul right away.
Yes, you do.
So with 1 second on the clock.
What was saying in that head that they didn't foul right away?
I don't know.
They're down two. They're gonna let the clock run out.
And Brown now has two shots.
And 1 second on the clock.
I make the first one, miss the second one.
Misses the first.
Maybe he's doing it the other way.
And maybe the intention was to miss, was to score the first. And miss the second.
You don't want.
That's it. Last year, they came in second. This time around, they reign supreme. The Knights,
Mama Coach,
UTEP Knights, welcome champions. They are gladiators. They are the reptiles. They are the champions. Caribbean Basketball Academy showing us a class. Their class.
A master class, you'll have to call it.
And teaching us exactly what we need to know about winning. Despair
Coach
on the face
Niren
of Coach Hurd.
Hurd.
And Coach Barker is running up court.
There are a number of persons he's pointing to in the sands and saying, I told you, I told you, I told you. But I'm sure he wasn't necessarily so confident earlier on in this game,
exactly.
But he has every reason to be that way right now.
Lewinson bailed them out.
I wouldn't call it a bailout. Lewinson is known for doing what he can do. He just didn't do it early enough to give it a runaway victory, but he did enough to give them the victory now that they needed it. And I have to say, this was a ball game of ball games. Coming back from where they came back from to actually now being champions, you got to hand it to them. The second place finisher last year, champions this year. Hats off to the Caribbean Basketball Academy.
Yeah. So while they celebrate, we'll take a break, come right back, hear from the coaches, and then we have the presentation.